There's this story, apocryphal perhaps. It reminds me of Steve Jobs in a garage somewhere with... It is that you two went to a dinner party, and there were people there with a camcorder, and they were all talking about how they could see other people's video and had no means to do that. Is that right? Is that a correct story?
Correct. It happened in January of 2005. It was up in my place in the city, in San Francisco. And we were having a dinner party, and people had digital cameras there, and we were taking normal digital photos as well as movies. And when we tried to share these, the photos, we found it very easy to share the photos with one another. But when we tried to share the movies, you know, we tried to email it back, but it just kept getting rejected, bounced back. We tried to upload, and you know, people have different video types, video codecs that you have to download, different software. So, you know, we sort of took a look at, with all the digital cameras now, with phones being able to take movies, that this was going to be more and more of a problem for other people. And we try to make and simplify this process to make it as easy as possible to share these videos online.
So what did you do? Did you leave that dinner party and say, you know, all of us have jobs? Well, three of you, right?
Yes.
Three of you, all from PayPal.
That's correct.
Correct, yeah.
Did you walk out of that dinner party saying, there's a business here, there's a company here?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we started thinking, and, you know, I think the YouTube has sort of gradually changed over time, but when we first started, it was just trying to share these clips with one another, and we started meeting in Chad's garage in Menlo Park. Yeah. Back to the Apple store, and we actually have video clips of us sort of drawing.
I think probably Wozniak was spending more time in the garage than Steve Jobs was.
Yeah. You know? And touching on our experience at PayPal, we saw the power of simplifying a process and giving everyone a solution. So in that case, you know, being early employees there, we did that for payments, and we saw the same opportunity here in the video space.
PayPal now owned by eBay?
That's correct. Yeah.
So you figured out, you went out and wrote some software, went out and got some venture capital. Once you got the site operating, who used it? And how fast did it grow?
Well, initially, we started developing the site in February of 2005. By May, we had the initial version of the site up and running.
Yeah.
And it was just personal clips that we were using with our friends. And, you know, just the viral nature of what we created, the easy-to-use features, the ways that people could grab links and embed these videos directly into their blogs and websites, it spread. So by December of 2005, we had our official launch. We were up to over 300 million videos served on a daily basis, and now that's scaled within a few months to over 100 million.
You went and got some venture capital money, too, from Sequoia or somebody.
That's correct, yes. Yeah.
With the number of people coming to the site, you obviously have something big here. Mm-hmm. How big can it be? What do you have? Do you have any sense of how fast you can grow and whether you can maintain the level of this exponential growth you've had?
Yeah. I mean, touching on our experiences again in the past, we have a team in place that's allowed us to have this architecture from day one so we can scale and keep up with growth and keep that under control because we've built our own technology.
And what would you like to see it become? The world's great marketplace for your own videos?
Yeah, in essence, yes. It's, you know, we see ourselves building the next generation platform to serve media worldwide, and we're doing that with a system that we're getting in place.
And is it fair to say that you believe that mainstream media cannot ignore this? I mean, they have to pay attention.
Well, it's giving you know, them a chance to get in front of a new audience. People are spending their time in different ways. They have choices now. It's beyond TV, they can play video games, they can be on cell phones, they can be on the internet. So it's about, you know, having an opportunity to get a piece of content in front of them. And we feel that's the best place to give them a chance to interact with that content and drive them back to the best experience, which would be on the TV or in the movie theater.
What's the biggest success that you have witnessed in terms of someone putting together an album or a piece of an album and finding enormous receptivity so that they, all of a sudden they had a hit on their hands?
Yeah, I mean, we've seen that on our site where users are
creating music, uploading it,
becoming discovered. We've had users sign record contracts. We had one user that was signed to Carson Daly Productions to develop a show. So this is now giving people a new opportunity to be seen, and that's what we see ourselves as doing, is you know, creating a stage for everyone to participate on.
A stage for anybody with a video camera.
Yeah, anyone.